A Child's Garden of Verses by Robert Louis Stevenson. Narrated by David J. Miles. To Alison Cunningham, from her boy. For the long nights you lay awake and watched for my unworthy sake, for your most comfortable hand that led me through the uneven land, for all the storybooks you read, for all the pains you comforted, for all you pitied, all you bore in sad and happy days of yore. My second mother, my first wife, the angel of my infant life, from the sick child, now well and old, take, nurse, the little book you hold, and grant it, heaven, that all who read may find as dear a nurse at need, and every child who lists my rhyme in the bright fireside nursery clime may hear it in as kind a voice as made my childish days rejoice. Bed in summer. In winter, I get up at night and dress by yellow candlelight. In summer, quite the other way, I have to go to bed by day. I have to go to bed and see the birds still hopping on the tree, or hear the grown-up people's feet still going past me in the street. And does it not seem hard to you when all the sky is clear and blue, and I should like so much to play, to have to go to bed by day? A thought. It is very nice to think the world is full of meat and drink, with little children saying grace in every Christian kind of place. At the seaside. When I was down beside the sea, a wooden spade they gave to me to dig the sandy shore. My holes were empty like a cup. In every hole the sea came up till it could come no more. Young night thought. All night long and every night, when my mamma puts out the light, I see the people marching by as plain as day before my eye. Armies and emperor and kings, all carrying different kinds of things, and marching in so grand a way, you never saw the like by day. So fine a show was never seen at the great circus on the green, for every kind of beast and man is marching in that caravan. As first they move a little slow, but still the faster on they go, and still beside me close I keep until we reach the town of sleep. Whole duty of children. A child should always say what's true, and speak when he is spoken to, and behave mannerly at table, at least as far as he is able. Rain. The rain is falling all around, it falls on field and tree, it rains on the umbrellas here, and on the ships at sea. Pirate story. Three of us afloat in the meadow by the swing, three of us abroad in the basket on the lee. Winds are in the air, they are blowing in the spring, and waves are on the meadow like the waves there are at sea. Where shall we adventure today that we're afloat, wary of the weather and steering by a star? Shall it be to Africa, a steering of the boat, to Providence or Babylon, or off to Malabar? Hi, but here's a squadron a-rowing on the sea. Cattle on the meadow a-charging with a roar. Quick, and we'll escape them. They're as mad as they can be. The wicket is the harbour, and the garden is the shore. Foreign lands. Up into the cherry tree, who should climb but little me? I held the trunk with both my hands and looked abroad in foreign lands. I saw the next door garden lie adorned with flowers before my eye, and many pleasant places more that I had never seen before. I saw the dimpling river pass, and by the sky's blue looking glass, the dusty roads go up and down with people tramping into town. If I could find a higher tree, farther and farther I should see, to where the grown-up river slips into the sea among the ships, to where the roads on either hand lead onward into fairyland, where all the children dine at five and all the playthings come alive. Windy nights. Whenever the moon and stars are set, Whenever the wind is high, all night long in the dark and wet, a man goes riding by. Late in the night, when the fires are out, why does he gallop and gallop about? Whenever the trees are crying aloud and ships are tossed at sea, by on the highway low and loud.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.